Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to the Pictou County Wellness Center for the final game of the day. Final game of the day here at the 2020 Hockey Nova Scotia Female Championship Weekend here at the Pictou County Wellness Center. It's in the Bantam AA category between the hometown Fundy Highland Northern Subway Selects and the Metro West Force Warriors. Warriors will be the road team in this game in their red jerseys, defending that to our right for the first and third periods. Selects will be the home team in white, defending the net to our left in periods one and three. Your starting goaltenders, Gabby Arsenault for the Selects, and Anna Wynn Sampson for the Metro West Force Warriors. And we are underway here at the Wellness Center, and the Warriors get possession right off the draw and are able to bring it into the Select zone. Cutting towards the net there was Monroe, but she ends up losing possession. It's picked up there by Bree McPherson. McPherson able to play it ahead. Selects get it out to center. Pass across. Here comes Evans. Evans coming in with the shot. She scores! 23 seconds is all it takes for the Selects to open the scoring, as Willa Evans quickly puts the hometown team out in front. They got off to a quick start in their game here on this sheet of ice earlier today. They did the same thing here. In fact, an even quicker start in this one than they did earlier today. Greencorn and Marks with the assists on that one. So again, it's Willa Evans from Kenzie Greencorn and Olivia Marks at the 23 second mark to open the scoring here in this one. Selects win the draw, puck played over to the near side for Fraser. She'll send it down low along the wall. In behind the net, going in there after it is Thompson. Puck comes back around the boards, and the Warriors able to get it out. Send into the Select zone, picked up again by Fraser. Fraser will work her way ahead. Fraser in across the blue line, takes the puck down low, trying to get to the outside against McLean. Also back there for the Warriors was Monroe. And now the Warriors come out with the puck. All the way down into the Select zone. Played around the boards. McLean will get to it at the line. She'll send it back down low. Goes in behind the net. Going after it there is Monroe. Monroe gets to it. She'll play it towards the near side corner. Turns, sends it towards the front of the net. There's a chance for Ogilvy. And the save made by Arsenault. And she'll hang on with a minute 46. Gone here in the first period. Off the faceoff, played back to Ogilvy. She'll send it down the glass and into the corner. Battle for it there as Josie Dunn trying to work it loose for the Selects. Working against the captain of the force. And now the puck comes free. And the selects force send McLean all the way back behind her own net. Puck turned over at the blue line as Smith was able to hold it in at least momentarily. Now the selects, Dunn gains the red line, dumps the puck in. Back to pick up there is Ogilvy. Ogilvy misplayed the puck slightly. Now it's Taylor down in the corner. Also in there is McLean, working against a couple of selects players. Puck is played loose. Pass ahead, gets to Girard, but she has it roll away from her, and the selects quickly get possession and turn it back up. That pass a little bit too far ahead of Beeson. She couldn't do much with that. And now McPherson will send it softly down into the Warriors' end. Picked up behind the net there by McDougal. McDougal trying to create some space for herself, but she's got a couple of white jerseys draped all over her. Puck is still tied up in that scrum as they battle along the end boards. Finally, it starts to get loose, and it does come loose, but we're going to get a penalty. Roughing is the call, and it'll go against the Warriors, Selah McDougal. At 3:36 of the first period, so Selah McDougal goes off for the rough, and the selects, who already have an early 1-0 lead, have a chance to possibly extend it here. Dunn plays the puck ahead. Perfect tape-to-tape pass received there by McNeil. Now McNeil takes it all the way behind the net. She has the puck knocked off her stick back there, and the Warriors are able to send it down the length of the ice. 1:35 left to go in the advantage. Here's Dunn with the puck. Josie Dunn will play it ahead. Now in the near side corner, four players in amongst the battle there. Hard to catch the numbers of who that is who's in there. Appears Georgia Gavis is one of them for the Warriors. Puck comes up the wall. There's a shot, save, rebound. Played back, there's another shot, another save. And this time, Sampson will cover it up and hang on for a faceoff. 53 seconds left in the power play. 10:17 left to go in the first period. Played back to LeBlanc off of the draw. She tries to send it back down low. That gets broken up. Dixon now gets it to the line. McPherson there waiting for it, but she has it taken from her. And we're going to get a whistle. I believe the puck bounced up and hit one of the Force players standing on their bench. And that's why the whistle was blown. Played back to McPherson again. She'll send it across for LeBlanc, and the selects bring it back into the zone. Sent towards the net, but it gets knocked down. Now picked up by Marks. She sends it back to the line. Attempted pass broken up, and now Smolders able to get it out. Along the near side wall. Selects get the puck back again and quickly bring it out here with 5 seconds left in the power play. Working down towards the corner is Marks. Marks stops there. Penalty has expired. We're back to 5-on-5. 9:18 to go, first period. Played back to the line. Shot from the point, hits a bunch of bodies in front. McEachern was the one who delivered that shot, and now Force with the puck, and it's played ahead. There's a pass, shot it, taken by Stevens, and that goes just wide. Now picked up by McDougal, played back to the line for McLean. McLean with the shot, too many bodies in front. Knocked down, now back to the line again, intended for McLean. But it'll be played ahead by the Selects. In the feet of Clark, she can't get it. And now here's Ogilvie. She'll send it down into the Select zone, and Arsenault will cover up and hang on for a faceoff. 8:26 left to go in the first period. Off of the draw, puck comes back to the point, shot taken and sent down into the corner. Now it comes back to the line. Day trying to work it down low a second time. She does. Down for Girard. Girard trying to create space for herself. Girard ends up losing the puck in the corner. And now another scrum will ensue. 8 minutes left to go in the period. Girard comes out with the puck. Girard sends it back down low. It'll be picked up there by Griffin. Griffin comes around to the near side. I can't see a thing that goes on in that corner, but now it comes out and Evans gets it ahead. Monroe plays it forward, now picked up there by Dixon. Dixon with the shot and the save made. .728 left to go, first period. Selects win the draw, take it behind the net. McPherson doesn't like the angle, so she comes back now to the near side. Has the puck knocked away from her there by Dixon. McPherson, though, able to win it back. Now they battle down behind the net. Dixon will come out with that. Dixon on it again. Plays it back to the line. Shot from the point by McDougal, and Arsenault makes the save and hangs on with 6:53 left to go here in the first period. Off the faceoff, puck sent behind the net. It bounces off the end boards. Warriors with another shot as they are pressing here after the Selects got the early goal. Puck played out to center and down the length of the ice. There on it is McNeil. McNeil stops in the corner, gets the puck out. Now there's a shot. It gets blocked in front and played out to center. On it is, for a moment, was Girard, but she gets taken off the puck, and it's picked up by Frazier. Here comes Frazier. Frazier throws it towards the front of the net. Thompson can't get a shot away. Smolders overskates the puck. Ogilvie takes a big whack and then swings her stick in response. Ogilvie was certainly hit with a check and then certainly swung her stick in response. Neither party innocent in that play. Puck dumped back into the zone by McEachern, and we're going to get an offside or an icing call against the Fundy Highland Subway Selects with 5:40 left to go in the first period. 1-0 the score for the Selects off the goal from Willa Evans. Played back to the line. McLean with the shot, that goes wide. comes off the boards. Haas sends it back to the line again. McLean back down behind the net, having trouble getting it settled, is Gavis. And that will allow the Selects to pick up the puck and get it out down the ice. Hustling back onto it is McLean. Plays it ahead, gets it out to center, but it'll be dumped back in again by LeBlanc. There's a potentially dangerous hit there as some high contact made on that sequence. But now here's Bree McPherson with the puck. As play goes on, McPherson into the Warrior zone, plays it back up the wall, but it's turned over, and here comes a potential two-on-one, maybe even a three-on-one rush. Pass over for Girard. Girard gets the shot away and the save made by Arsenault. And now McPherson gets on the puck, and the Selects are able to play it out to center. Back to get it there, Boudreaux. She'll play it across to the near side. Picked up by Beeson. She'll get it down and into the Warrior zone. Comes all the way around to the near side boards with 4:10 left to go in the period. Coming off of the wall with it was Greencorn. She made the pass. The shot gets deflected well wide. Now Boudreaux plays it ahead and out to center. Comes out to center again, across to the far side for McEachern. She'll dump it in around the near side. Battle in the corner. Puck played ahead, and now it's turned over at the Warrior blue line. Here comes Duck. Duck has it knocked away from her. Couple of chances there as Smolders took a couple whacks at it, but it ends up going wide. 3:10 left to go, first period. There with it is Griffin. She gets it in across the line, but got knocked off the puck, and now just outside the Select blue line. Now it's right in front of the benches. Gavis there battling. Eventually the Selects get possession and Dunn will play it out, or down. Knocked down there by McDougal. She turns it back up the other way. Pass for Haas near side. Haas lost it at the blue line. Taylor has to wait for Haas to get back on side and then loses it to Thompson. Thompson will play it back for LeBlanc. Up ahead, as the puck is dumped into the Warrior zone, and off of the faceoff, puck sent down towards the corner, wrapped around the boards now. Off the glass, LeBlanc gets it to the line, held in there by Taylor. Now it comes out, McNeil, she can't get it under control. Thompson trying to settle it down, and she'll back it up for McNeil. McNeil able to skate through that check, and now here's McDonald, Julia McDonald, down towards the corner. McDonald cuts to the middle, takes the shot, and the save made. 1:47 left to go in the first period. Played down. Now ahead for Girard. Girard gets it across, and here comes Boudreaux. Monroe, not eight. Down into the corner where I can't see a thing. Now out front, there's a shot that goes just wide. Played to the line. Another shot bounces in. Now it comes back to Boudreaux. Arsenault made the first save. Pressure still on here with 1:05 to go in the period. Fired down the length of the ice. It will just hit the post, and so no icing. And now here comes the Warrior rush yet again. There's another shot, save. And hanging on to it this time is Arsenault with 43.2 seconds left to go in the first period. Into the corner, wrapped around to the near side and into the corner. Now back around to the far side. Clark out with it into center, knocked away from her, and now the Warriors look to play it ahead again, but it's going to be a penalty, slashing the indication against Ellie Clark at 14:37 of the first period. So the Warriors will get their first power play of the game here with 23.8 seconds left to go in this first period. Haas comes in to take the draw for the Warriors. Puck rolls right in onto Arsenault, and she'll cover up and hang on for a faceoff. Cleared down the length of the ice. First one on it is actually Evans, as the Selects penalty killers. Some good aggressive forecheck there. That'll run things out of time, as Taylor couldn't get the puck in to get a shot away before the period comes to an end. And so despite being outshot 6-2, the Selects will carry a 1-0 lead into the intermission.
Sir, I hate to be a pain, but the reason I have to take you is because I can't see in that corner.
So we'll get the second period going here with 's on the power play here for another minute 29 at the start of this period. Here's Gavis with the puck. She'll give it to McLean. McLean's shot, that gets blocked. Trying to get a shot away again, but it's sent down the length of the ice as the Selects penalty killers coming in a hurry. Puck wrapped around the boards. It'll be picked up in neutral ice and sent back into the Warrior zone there. Into the second minute of the penalty here. All the way down behind the net for the Warriors. That's McLean. She gets taken to the boards and loses the puck, and it's fired down the ice yet again. Going back to pick up this time is Monroe. Monroe behind the net, comes out the far side, gets angled towards the board. An attempted dump back down, gets fanned on. And now here comes McGregor. McGregor plays it back. Back to the line now. Skating it along the line was Day. Back to McGregor. 15 seconds left in the penalty. Actually, that's McGregor there with it now. She takes the shot. It's knocked down by the bodies in front. Comes to McDougal. Her shot does get through. Kick save. Puck to the far wall. And out to center. as we're back to even strength. Here's a chance for the selects coming in. And just getting a piece of that puck with her glove is Sampson. Out to center. And now with it, they're bringing it into the zone. Griffin trying to set it to Thompson. That doesn't connect. Thompson chases back to get the puck in neutral ice. Has it knocked away from her. Now it's played to the blue line. And out for Smolders. Smolders will send it down into the select zone. Picking up for the selects is Thompson as she works her way ahead. Thompson still with it. Thompson down to the corner. Now she'll play it behind the net for McDonald. McDonald gets tied up and coming in to pick up the puck is Gavis. She gets it up as far as the line, held in momentarily there by McEachern. But then she could not continue to hold the line and it was dumped out. Selects get the pressure right back on again. Dunn trying to dump it back in after it came out. Now a lead pass into the near side corner. Girard going in after it. She'll get it back. There's Smolders with a chance and she fans on that opportunity. 3:10 gone here, second period, 1-0 for the selects. There's a shot and a save made by Sampson and she'll hang on for the faceoff. And just noticed some big news in the world of women's hockey from earlier today. The IIHF has decided to postpone, actually not postpone, unfortunately cancel the IIHF Women's World Hockey Championships, which were scheduled to be played here in Nova Scotia. The cancellation coming due to the continued outbreak of coronavirus. The IIHF making the decision, or announcing the decision earlier today, that there will not be a Women's World Hockey Championships this year, as we've got a penalty coming up and it's going to be against the Warriors. Although both players could certainly now they're gonna talk it over and see what they're gonna call. And it's gonna be two each for roughing, coincidental penalties. Here at 3:37. And hard to believe, but this being the 14th game I've called this weekend, and that's the first set of coincidental penalties I think I've seen all weekend. 14 games and one set of coincidental penalties to this point. That is impressive to say the least. Two each for roughing. Lead pass for Duck. Duck with the shot. That gets deflected and goes well wide. Now played to the line. Shot gets deflected in front of the net. Doesn't get all the way through to Arsenault. Now it'll be cleared down the ice. That'll be an icing call. Or will it? No, icing gets waved off as the puck dies just before getting to the goal line there. Working her way ahead there is Gavis. Now the puck ends up with Monroe. She'll get it in and played back out down the ice. again, not hard enough for an icing, is back to get it, is McDougal. 10:22 left to go, second period, 1-0 selects. Out to center. Here comes McGregor. McGregor taking it down into the near side corner, trying to center it. That was broken up by Thompson. Now in behind the net, McEachern. She'll play it around to the near side for Marks. Marks wraps it around to the far boards. It gets just past her intended target of Evans, and the selects continue to go back and forth and back and forth behind their own net. Now they come out. Boudreaux picks up the puck just inside her own blue line. Ahead for Taylor. Taylor has it knocked off her stick by McPherson as the two respective captains meet there in neutral ice. Now Taylor brings the puck in. Taylor gets a shot through. Arsenault makes the save and hangs on with 9:29 left to go here in period number one. Off the faceoff, neither player able to win it cleanly. Puck comes to the wall. Thompson now creating some space. Gets it around to the far side for McNeil. McNeil able to play it out to center. Hustling over to get to the puck is McLean. Now Taylor brings it back into the zone. Taylor elects to shoot. Toe save made by Arsenault. Now McLean. Deflected by Taylor, and Arsenault another big save. With 8:58 left to go here in the second period. Again, this the final game of the day here on this side of the ice for the 2020 Hockey Nova Scotia Female Provincial Championships. Final game of the day, just getting underway over on the other side of the ice, but we do have one more game on each sheet after this. Both of those will be available on 360 Live. The Nova Scotia Major Bantam Provincial Playoff Series between the Excel Physio and Wearwell Bombers will be played over on the Bell Alliant rink. You can catch that game on 360 on the Nova Scotia Major Bantam channel. And here on this sheet on the Nova Scotia Major Midget channel, you'll be able to catch the week's Major Midgets and the South Shore Mustangs. We still have 8:20 left to go in the second period of this one though, plus the whole third period. With the selects leading it just 1-0. Here now is McGregor. She'll bring the puck in across the blue line. McGregor works it down to the corner. Picked up there by Girard. Girard out front. There's a shot. Save. Rebound. Cleared away to the corner. Fraser gets it as far as the line, and now it's out to center. Hustling back to get on that puck was Dixon. She gets it ahead to McDougal. McDougal plays it forward, and now the selects come back into the Warrior zone. Warriors certainly controlling the majority of the play here, but the selects playing with a lead right now as we just pass the midway point of this second period. Here's Duck with it now. Duck trips up as she goes over the blue line. Taylor getting to that puck just before it leaves the zone. And now it is sent out. Hustling back to get to it is Day. Day stops behind the net. She'll give it over to Hawes. Hawes plays it, tried to play it out, but it ends up being turned over to Greencorn. Greencorn couldn't get much of a shot away. Now Greencorn helping to tie it up. But the Warriors get it, and out they come. McPherson creates a turnover. Day gets it at her own line, plays it across. Now another turnover as the selects trying to pick up the pace here a little bit with 6.5 to go in the second period. Played across to the far side. Bouchard picks up there, or Boudreau, excuse me. Boudreau, another pass that gets intercepted. And now Bree McPherson will come in, pick up the loose puck, but she has it knocked from her. 6:12 left. Gavis plays it ahead. Dunn going after, or LeBlanc going after it, but it will reach the goal line for an icing. With the Selects up 1-0, 6:08 left to go here, second period. Selects already with one victory earlier today. Puck played out down the ice. Frazier hustling back to get it. She'll take it back behind the net. Turns, changes direction. Played ahead now. And here comes Griffin. Griffin has it knocked off her stick. There's a shot taken by Stevens in the save made by Arsenault. Picking it up once again is Marks. She'll get it ahead. And it's played out to center. Griffin gets the puck in as Gavis and McNeil collide in center ice. Neither one of them initiated the hit. They just plain old ran into each other. Here's a move by Haas. And what a save by Arsenault. She looked behind her to be sure, but made the save with 5:06 left on the clock. Monroe in to take the draw, wins it back to McDougal. McDougal sends it down to the corner. Duck plays it behind the net for Monroe. Monroe out the far side. Tries to reverse field to get it back behind the net, but nobody there for the Warriors. Now they do get the puck back anyway. Played to the line to McDougal. McDougal just holds it onside, gets the shot down, looking for a deflection from Duck, but Duck couldn't redirect it enough to get it on target. There's another shot, and Arsenault with a save. 4:38 remaining here in period number two. Back to the line, shot from the point, taken by Dixon. It ends up, or that's Gavis, excuse me. No, that was Dixon. Down in the corner there. It's hard to read the numbers on some of these Warriors jerseys with the black number on the red jersey. There's not quite enough contrast to see it clearly. Similarly, the yellow number on the white jersey. Not a whole lot of contrast there either. Out come the Selects. Puck rolled towards the net, cleared away by McDougal. Picked up again. Now here's a shot, and that one doesn't miss by a whole bunch. Out in front, picked up, there's a shot and a save made by Sampson. Just the fifth shot that she's faced here tonight. But one has been able to sneak past her. Whereas at the other end of the ice, Gabby Arsenault has not given up any to this point. Taking it behind the net, Boudreau brings it around. Now worked ahead as Taylor got it up to Gavis. Gavis down into the Select zone. With 3:33 left to go here in the second period. Fa- Face off. Day able to get the puck around the boards for Haas. Haas takes a bump there. And getting to it, Boudreaux. She brings it back around to the near side. Now reverses field again. Sends it up towards the middle of the ice. Nearly a costly mistake, but able to get it back, get it ahead. Now is working down the ice there was Haas. There's a shot, and it rolls all the way in onto Arsenault, and she'll make the save and hang on. 2:58 left to go in the second period. Face off to the right of Gabby Arsenault. Puck played back to the line. Comes to McLean, her shot, and Arsenault able to see that one all the way in. And makes no mistake about it, covers up and hangs on. 2:52 remaining in period number two. Selects lead it 1-0, as they have since just 23 seconds into this game. The goal from Willa Evans, opening the scoring in the opening minute, and nothing else since. There's a shot that gets blocked in front by Dunn. Selects not able to clear. Warriors with another shot. That gets deflected but comes into the near corner. 2.5 to go, second period. They battle in the corner, working ahead. Thompson. And Thompson's going to take a penalty here as she delivered the hit. And so the Selects will go shorthanded for the second time in this game. Penalty coming at 12:44. Puck gets to the line. McDougal holds it in there. McDougal gives to Gavis. Gavis back to McDougal again. To Gavis. Gavis, her cross ice pass gets deflected, and it's played out to center by Clark. McDougal to Gavis. Gavis gets it ahead, but puts it right on the stick of Josie Dunn, and Dunn able to send it down the ice yet again. 1:28 left to go in the penalty. McDougal. Gavis near side. Starts to work her way ahead. Gavis cutting through the center of the ice. Now in across the blue line far side. Plays it back to Taylor. Taylor to McDougal. McDougal with the shot. Off the end boards. Puck comes up the wall. And Clark able to get it out to center. Taylor back to pick up. She's being pestered there by Greencorn. We're going to get another penalty. And it's going to be a body check against Taylor as she took Greencorn down. So we'll play 4-on-4 for 49 seconds. And then the Selects will have a power play of their own for a minute 11. Most of that will occur in the second period. As the week's major midgets getting their warm-ups in, getting ready for a big game tonight. That'll be happening on this sheet of ice, and again, we will have it for you here on 360 Live. We're into the final minute of the period here. As with the puck there, now played back to, that was LeBlanc. Oh yeah. I'm just in the middle of doing play-by-play, hard to chat. Yeah. As if my wife is watching, your friend Buffy just came by and said hi. Puck played out to center. And now back in with 5 seconds left in the period. And it'll be cleared down the ice. That'll do it for period number two. And we'll get the intermission with the Selects carrying 55 seconds of power play time into the third and carrying the slimmest of 1-0 leads into the third period as well. We'll take the break. We'll come back. Get you ready for that third period in just a few minutes. You are watching Bantam AA action at the 2020 Hockey Nova Scotia Female Championship Weekend here on 360 Live, powered by Bell. Welcome back as we get ready for the start of the third period here. Selects lead it by a 1-0 margin despite being outshot right now 12-5 by the Metro West Force Warriors. ...15 minutes separating the Selects from victory if they can hang on. And they start this third period with 55 seconds of power play time remaining. Puck played out and back down the length of the ice. Arsenault will set it up there for Bree McPherson. McPherson, the captain, working her way ahead in across the blue line. Has the puck knocked off her stick. And now they continue to battle for it. Thompson will get it down low around the boards. First one on the puck there will be McLean. Played to the line, held in again by McPherson. Now down to Thompson. In behind the net. McDonald can't get the puck, but it comes to the line. Dunn, her pass across, ends up coming out of the zone as the penalty to Wilson expires. Or Taylor, where I got Wilson from, I don't know. Here's McPherson. Not able to maintain control as the play comes down into the Select zone. Just over a minute 20 gone here in the third period. Played deep into the Metro West end as the Selects work the forecheck there, trying to keep the puck away from Boudreau. Now in behind the net, goes to Day. Day can't maintain it, however. Out in front, and it's going to come all the way back to the line. Sent back down low again by McEachern. Behind or beside the net, Smith plays it back, and it ends up going all the way out as Frazier has to chase it down, plays it back ahead. Over 2 minutes gone here in the third period. McEachern not able to hold the line as Smolders comes out. McDougal now with the puck. McDougal down into the corner. Has it knocked away from her as Frazier able to get possession. Frazier trying to tie it up. She takes a hit to the back. No call there. After some non-calls that the Warriors questioned earlier, Select fans left questioning a non-call on that play. Here's Frazier with the puck. Sending it ahead, picked up by Evans. She has the only goal of this game. It came way back, 23 seconds into the first period. There's a shot from a sharp angle by Smith, steered aside by Sampson. Clearing pass comes out. Smolders was heading to the bench for a change, turned long enough to play the puck and then go off. The coach wisely didn't open the door until after Smolders had played the puck to make sure that nobody went out onto the ice and the Warriors didn't end up getting caught with too many players. Puck rolls in onto Arsenault. She'll cover up and hang on for a faceoff. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the third period. Reminder once again, one more game left here tonight after this one. It will not be on the same channel, however. You're going to have to switch over to the Nova Scotia Major Midget Hockey League channel for game three of the series between the Weeks Major Midgets and the South Shore Lumberjacks. Dunn has the puck, backs up with it, plays it ahead. If you're looking for the major bantam game, that'll be played on the other sheet of ice after we wrap up the day here at the Tournament of Champions or the Weekend of Champions. You'll need to go to the Major Bantam channel. Puck rolls in onto Arsenault and she'll cover up and hang on. And that'll be game three of the series between Excel Physio and the Werewell Bombers. It's a best of three, so the winner of that series, or the winner of that game, will advance to the provincial championship weekend next weekend in Antigonish. And guess what? We'll have all of the action from that tournament for you next weekend here on 360 Live. There's a shot and a big save by Arsenault again. As we take a quick look, we'll actually look at that later, but McNeil lets the puck go. It's picked up by Duck. Duck down to the corner. Duck behind the net now. There's a chance out in front. The puck is going to be batted away from danger. Gets to the line. Dixon tries to send it back in deep, but it's knocked away. And now here comes McNeil. She gets taken down. McPherson tries to jab at the puck. And now at the line, having to wait for a teammate to get back onside was the Warrior player. That was Smolders. Now Duck chases the puck down in the corner. Puck gets to the line and out, dumped down the ice. That'll be an icing call. 9:26 left to go here in period number two, or three. Played out to center. McLean back in her own zone, looking to build some speed as she comes out to center, has the puck knocked off her stick, recovers it, and brings it in across the line, but she had to make one little extra move at the blue line. And so we'll get the stoppage on the offside. Played down the ice there by Dunn. And that's going to be an icing call. 8:51 left to go. Still a lot of hockey left to be played in this game. And that tenuous 1-0 lead for the Selects over the Warriors. Linesman saw something she didn't like prior to the puck drop, so we'll get Stevens waved out of the faceoff circle. And Gerard will have to come in and take the draw. Draw one by Griffin. But the Selects not able to clear as the puck was taken away from Frazier. Battle in the corner. Frazier plays it up the wall. Boudreau will send it back in deep. Now in towards the corner. Griffin, Frazier, both in there for the Selects. Stevens and McGregor in there for the Warriors. 8:15 now left in the third period. Played off the wall. McGregor holds it and sends that one through into the near side corner. Dunn. She'll work her way ahead out to center. Dunn doesn't get the puck past the Warrior defenders, but following up on the play and carrying it ahead was Smith. She got it all the way down into the corner. Now a pass intercepted by McPherson. McPherson can't get much on that shot, as it was blocked. Now Monroe plays it around to the near side. Up the wall. And out to center. Duck loses the puck to McPherson. Bree McPherson gets it over. Here's a chance. Shot, save, rebound, another save as Sampson has to come up big twice in rapid succession there. Over halfway through this third period, Select still leading 1-0 as it's been since 23 seconds into the game. Nearly doubling up their lead there, but Sampson came up with a couple of big saves. Now the pressure back on the Select defenders as they get it down the ice. That's going to be an icing call. 6:56 on the clock here. As we await a couple of big games here tonight. This a big game, certainly. Couple more big games coming up in about 45 minutes. Werewell Bombers and Excel Physio, one of those teams, and only one of those teams, will be going to provincials. Whoever wins that game will go to provincials. The spot for highest ranked losing team has been claimed by the South Shore Lumberjacks. It could still get claimed actually by an even higher ranked team, but the Novas, who are the hosts, have won their way in, so the highest ranked non-winning team will get in, but it will not be the Werewell Bombers, as a team ranked above them in the standings has already lost their series. So it is a must-win game. Meanwhile, here we've got Ogilvy taking the puck down. She tries to get a shot through, but it's blocked nicely there by the captain, Bree McPherson. Ogilvy gets it again. She kind of fans on that shot. And now, as LeBlanc and McPherson played catch behind the net, now it's played out to center. 5:45 left to go. LeBlanc gets it ahead. Knocked down. And back to pick up is McDonald. She tries to play it ahead. That's knocked down as well. In behind the net with it is McPherson. Bree McPherson working it forward. Off the wall, Boudreau sends it back deep. Now a little higher off the wall. Into the glass even. Boudreau again able to knock it down. Boudreau a third time keeps that puck in the zone and then fires a shot, but that goes wide. 5:06 on the clock as the Selects now starting to try and look at this clock as an ally. Here comes Thompson. A one goal margin, not enough to really use that clock as an ally just yet though. Thompson gets taken down behind the net and we're going to get a tripping penalty. And so the Selects will go to the power play for the second time tonight. 4:48 left to go here in the third period. Fiona Day goes off for the trip. Puck wrapped around the boards to the line, held in there. Now across to the far side, there's a shot. It goes off the outside of the net. Tied up behind the net. And with a couple of players getting knocked down near that scramble, we'll get the face-off. .425 left to go, third period. Puck cleared down the ice. Haas on the forecheck, even though they're shorthanded, tried to tuck a quick puck in, not able to do so. Now it's sent down the ice. Haas. Puck played towards the front of the net, bounces down, and now They battle in the far corner. 58 seconds left in the power play. 3:44 left to go in the period. Puck played out. Sent down the ice. Going back to pick up is the captain, McPherson. Bree McPherson. Plays it ahead. Now Stevens trying to get back into the select zone. She has it, her pocket picked. And with 25 seconds left in the power play, puck played to the near side. Back to the line now for Fraser. She goes across to Dunn. Josie Dunn with the shot and the save made by Sampson. Puck off of Dunn and just out to center. It also went off of the skate of the linesman. Coming back to help out Thompson. Dunn now trying to get the puck into the zone. She can't. We're back to 5-on-5. And 2:45 left to go here in the third period. There's a shot, and Arsenault makes the save, and she'll hang on for a faceoff with 2:42 now showing. Off of the draw, down to the corner. Played to the line and swinging and missing there was Day, that was McDougal, but she was able to recover enough to get back on the back check. 2:23 and counting, third period, puck comes to the line. Fraser, near side McNeil. McNeil with the shot, it goes off of Boudreaux and into the corner. Sent behind the net. McDougal getting tied up there by McDonald, but now out come the Warriors. Here come the Warriors. Here's a chance. Shot, they score! With 1:54 left in regulation, this game is all tied up. A huge goal there to tie up the game with 1:54 left in regulation. The jersey was tucked in, so I didn't see who took the shot. I think it might have been Monroe. We'll have to wait for the announcement to be sure. It is indeed Monroe who gets the goal. Boudreaux and Duck with the assists. So here we are into the final 90 seconds of regulation now. And we might see our third overtime game of the weekend here on this sheet of ice, although the Warriors are pressing. And any of you watching at home, if you have your speakers turned up a little too high, I apologize for any ear damage you may be suffering right now. But the Warrior fans, understandably, picking up the volume with a big goal late in regulation to tie it up. Played back into the zone after it was cleared out. McPherson now gets it ahead. McPherson has it knocked back to her again. Now out to center. McLean up for Duck. It's knocked off her stick. Now Dunn. Into the final 45 seconds of regulation. We had the first game of the day go to overtime yesterday. We had the game just prior to this one go to overtime, and we're 30 seconds away from that possibility here. What a play by Dunn on the back check to knock the puck away from Taylor. Now Dunn in the corner, battling with Taylor. 19 seconds left in regulation. It's played out to center. Back to pick up there was Dixon. She has it taken away from her. Here's a chance shot and a big save made by Sampson in the dying seconds. That's going to do it for regulation. We're going to go to overtime. 1-1 the score after regulation. We'll take a quick break and come back. All right. Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Everybody lined up. There was still... Everybody lined up, but there was still 29 seconds left in the two-minute break. They dropped the puck before Billy was ready down in the penalty box. Duck trying to get the puck into the line as the overtime period is underway. Back with it now, Thompson. She'll play it across. McPherson, long lead pass, too far for McNeil. That'll be an icing. With 20 seconds gone in the overtime, both games that have gone to overtime on this sheet of ice ended in ties. Do we finally get an OT winner? Or are we going to see our third tie and our second consecutive tie here on this sheet of ice in the Sobeys Arena here at the Pictou County Wellness Center? Puck comes towards the front of the net. There's a chance, and it's cleared to the wall. McPherson trying to circle away from danger. McPherson changes direction yet again and then makes a pass across. Day will hold it in at the line, send it back down low. Thompson picks up, gets it ahead. And McDonald gets it out to center. McDonald still with the puck. Day back checking hard. And they're going to call Day for a hook there. So the selects will go to the power play here 59 seconds into the overtime. With a chance to try and win it with the extra attacker, or not the extra attacker, but the power play. 4:01 left in overtime. A big power play for the selects, a huge kill for the Warriors. Draw one, back to Dunn. Dunn played it across to Frazier, but it ended up coming out to center. Back in again. Beeson loses it. And hustling back to get the puck there is Frazier. Frazier looking ahead. She'll play the puck up. Smith makes a pass across. Return pass for Smith. But she couldn't get her stick on that one to get a shot away. Not able to clear the zone. Now with it, McDougal plays it ahead, but still not able to clear the zone as it's held in by Griffin. Over to Smith. Smith again can't get a shot through. McDougal tries to clear. She does. As Dunn got a glove on it, but wasn't able to keep it onside. And then it results in an offside with 1:08 left in the power play. 3:09 left here in overtime. We still have one more game left after this one. It'll be in the Major Midget channel here on 360 Live. Game three of the best of seven series between the South Shore Mustangs and the week's Major Midgets. Play it into the near side. 51 seconds left in the power play. McPherson with the shot, knocked down in front. Puck comes back to McPherson, another shot, that goes off a body. And now Haas comes out. Haas works around. Haas down behind the net, throws it out in front, comes all the way back to the line. Dixon with the shot. And she got run into just as she delivered that shot. Now we're gonna get a penalty against McPherson. So we'll play 4-on-4 for 23 seconds. And then the Warriors will go to the power play for pretty much the rest of the overtime. 2:24 remains in the overtime period. So if they don't take advantage of their power play, there'd be just 24 seconds left when we get back to even strength. 12 seconds left of the 4-on-4. Puck is in the corner. Thrown towards the front. Cleared away. Now here's the lead pass. Coming up is Smith. Smith gets taken down. Selects are now shorthanded. But on the puck there. Now it comes ahead for Stevens. Stevens across. There's a shot. They score! The power play goal for the Warriors gives them the 2-1 victory. And by virtue of that reaction, I can only assume that means they have earned a berth in tomorrow's final. With, like I said, I haven't been able to get yesterday's results, so I can't say who will meet in the final now. I can tell you the selects. Obviously disappointed right now, but they had themselves a great effort this evening. The final score, 2-1 for the Warriors. And so now we'll have the presentation of the players of the game, and then we'll take a break and get ready to bring you the Major Midget game between the Weeks and the Mustangs. That's scheduled to start in 26 minutes. We will be late getting that game started because they still... And Gabby Arsenault gets player of the game for the selects. She did everything she could to keep her team going. And Claire Monroe is player of the game for the Warriors. I never did hear the announcement of the overtime winner, but that's going to do it for this one. The Warriors win 2-1. We'll be back with you in about 20 minutes for the Mustangs and the Weeks. Until then, this is Michael Petter saying, may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Thanks for watching. We'll be back with you very soon.